guy who struggled just to get to the big leagues to forge a legacy in a city over this kind of time period, not only with fans, but with players, everybody who was associated with him.
That's an excellent
point. Even us.
That's an excellent point. And, you know, for a guy that had to fight so hard to get to the big leagues, and the next thing, you know, he's hitting a walk-off in a playoff series, and then into a leadership role, two-time All-Star for a guy that, that was a career minor leaguer for a while. Once he got here, he took advantage of the opportunity to be at the big leagues as well as anybody I've ever seen. So, he definitely made an impact here. Not only, like you said, with us and the clubhouse, but the media, the fans, everybody. I think that was in respect to him, because he wanted, you know, he saw the playing time being cut back some, and he wanted to know how he could get that playing time back. And David was good enough to sit with him and, you know, explain the situation. So a little bit of a heavy heart when he came out here. I mean, it wasn't for sure. You never know what can happen over the course of a 3-hour baseball game, 4-hour game, whatever it is nowadays. But, I think there was a little bit of a reflective mood when he was out here, but I think David did the right thing in letting him know kind of where he stood.
Stephen said a lot of guys, teammates stuck around after the game yesterday to say goodbye. Was it your sense that any of the other players knew before the game or during the game what was going on?
I do not know that at all. Obviously, that's not the only move you guys made this morning. What was the status of Chapman that led you guys decide to be out?
Yeah, you know, and I was talking about it yesterday that he was making strides, and he was, but the medication that they were giving him plateaued, so to speak, so they're going to be a little bit more aggressive with it and give him a drip as far as the antibiotics that hopefully would be more aggressive and speed it up. Having said that, it's probably prudent to put him on the DL and not try to rush him back. But he has been getting better. As it looks like it took a turn for the worse. It didn't. They're just trying to be a little bit more aggressive in the treatment.
Nice to have the 10-day DL for something like that.
Yeah, you backdated 4, so it could potentially be 6 days. And, you know, we'll see how he does in the coming days. And if he feels great, maybe we get him a game or so at, you know, Stockton or wherever. Or we just get him right back in the lineup. But the 10-day DL, obviously, is a lot, you know, in a situation like this, is a bonus.
About having Olson here, you got him in the lineup right away. And is he going to be semi-regular or?
We'll see how it goes. I mean, you know, haven't really looked farther than today. There was a lot going on last night, certainly the Chapman situation coming back. But as of right now, he's been swinging back really well. Now, he's a first baseman, and he's a plus first baseman, but we're trying to find a way to get him in the lineup. You know, obviously, Yonder's going to play first, and he's been good enough in right field and has played out there enough to be comfortable there, and it's just as much about getting his bat in the lineup and getting some at-bats for him.
Stephen, who do you see?
You know what, there are certain unique leaders that you don't replace. You just try to kind of fill in around. So, like I said, we've done this many times here where, you know, we've had these conversations about where do you go from here with X. And, you know, the other guys are going to have to fill in. And we do have some veteran guys here. And we have quite a few guys in the bullpen. I'm guessing Sean Doolittle now is our most tenured guy here. But the Ryan Madsons and, you know, even guys like Yonder now are veterans. Jed's a veteran. We have some guys. It's just a little different when you have a guy that was the one guy that you would say when you're asking about the Oakland A's, who's the leader in the clubhouse.
You guys have a great combo. There wasn't a day here that Stephen wasn't trying to make somebody else better.
Right.
Obviously, he can still continue to play, but a guy like that, you would think, would have a long future of baseball after he's done.
No doubt. And I was asked the other day about, you know, and I get a couple times a year asked about future managers, and he is definitely one of those guys. You know, he does. He goes out of his way to try to touch everybody on a daily basis. And, you know, he even said to me, texted me this morning, you know, tell Bruce to, you know, make sure he's in there with those pitches. You know, he's still kind of here with us even today, so that's just the kind of guy he is.
Is Jed banged up at all or just getting a day
off?
No,
this was a day. We just we scheduled this one.
Uh-huh.
I knew about it for a few years. It's not an easy one to give them, having lost three games in a row to these guys.
Yeah.
You know, we want to keep them healthy. We want to keep them, you know, fresh to where you don't have to give them a couple days if you feel like he's run down a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm interested in Fegley and Nashville being just having exposure to Stevens for a couple years.
Yeah, I think it's probably a question for them, but my answer would be a lot. And they should be, and they should have used him as a resource. I know Fegs has been around him quite a bit. He'll have nothing but glowing things to say about him. You know, Bruce is a guy that hasn't been around him as much other than full-time in spring training, but I'm sure he's been impactful to him as well. All right, thank you.